The second week of the Oscar Pistorius trial saw key evidence, key physical evidence being brought before the court. Not only was the cricket bat and the door in court, but we also saw crime scene photographs, often at times upsetting ones. Reeva Steenkamp's body accidentally flashed up on the TV screens in court a few times, causing Oscar Pistorius to retch violently, have a physical reaction to these images. But I think from what was very crucial in terms of the legal debate, we saw again an expanding of the differences of the narratives between both the defense and the state, whether or not Oscar Pistorius had his prosthetic legs on, specifically when he was using the cricket bat to bash down the door. Also very crucial in this week's testimony came these very damning allegations of police conduct. Take a listen to this.
And at that particular moment, the ballistic expert was having the firearm in his hand without gloves. He already took out the magazine was in his hand, and the firearm was in his hand. So I stopped immediately talking and I asked him, "What are you doing?" And then he turned his head to me and he was looking, and then he realized there was no hand gloves on. And then he said, "Sorry," and he put the magazine back in the firearm and he put it back on the carpet, this bathroom carpet.
Now, it wasn't just the gun that was contaminated. We also heard how watches of Pistorius's went missing during the police investigation. A number of allegations, not just of police complacency and mishandling, but also of bias and specifically of tampering with the crime scene. This, of course, is a theme that's going to continue into the third week as the defense continues to look to chip away at the credibility of the investigation. Robyn Curnow, CNN, Pretoria.